make a baby. You deserve to just fall apart.
I might.
Well, if you do, I'll take care of you. Okay?
You don't want to give me anything I need, okay? That's fair.
Nothing's fair, Bette. You broke everything that meant anything to me.
Let me fix it.
No.
I won't accept that.
Too bad. I don't know how you could keep this baby a secret from me.
I don't know how you could lie to me for nearly 4 months. I mean, we were still together. We were a couple, and you were pregnant, and I had no idea.
I planned to tell you, and then you fucked off.
I fucked up. I did not fuck off. I did not leave. I am still here.
I never got to say how happy I am for you. For us.
Where am I supposed to go? I don't know, just move into the other bedroom until we figure it out. I just don't want you in my bed anymore. Please believe me, Tina.
Look, I've changed my mind. I don't want you to adopt my daughter. Henry and I are thinking about starting a family, and we want Angelica to be a full part of that.
Don't do this. I'm warning you.
Back to the safety of white heterosexual privilege.
Safety? This is about the bravest thing I've ever done. I stand to lose all my friends who view me as some sort of turncoat.
They don't hate you because of your sexual orientation, Tina. They hate you because you can't be trusted not to use it against me when it comes to sharing custody of our child.
Oh, here we go with the trust thing again. That is so...
I know our relationship was real. I know you loved me. And it wasn't just some trivial experiment to you. I still love you, you know? I love you too.
When your work, your needs, your ideas are always right, always on a higher plane, you're more enlightened, you're more informed, you're more intuitive.
It must have been hideous. I'm sorry.
I'm sorry.
I'll take it over the safe, boring man I've been seeing here all day.
I would do anything for another chance.
I'm not afraid to make a fool out of myself.
I don't know what to do. You're in love with Jody, right?
I adore her, and I respect and admire her, but
what?
It doesn't really compare.
You didn't have to accept the invitation.
I thought it was coming from both of you.
Why would I invite you to bring some girl who's after you to Jody's dinner party?
I don't know. I thought it was something that you wanted. You know, you're the one that's with Jody. I'm with whoever the fuck I'm with. No one.
And you and I just are... We just have some kind of fling? And you're okay with that?
It's kind of a foregone conclusion, don't you think?
No. No, it's not. Not for me.
I'm afraid that I'm destructive. That if I have something good, I feel compelled to destroy it.
Look, I'm not so pure and innocent, okay? I was awful. When I was with Henry, I was flailing. Look how I treated you. I used Angelica against you. I was despicable.
At a certain point, I have to trust that they're like our family. Just because we leave LA doesn't mean that we're leaving them.
I really wanted to go.
It'll be a fresh start.
It's a new city.
It's gonna be so exciting.
New York.
What?
I'd like to marry you.
Really?